With social distancing being advised and even enforced by executive order in states like Virginia, a legitimate question has been asked and deserves an answer. How should the public interact with law enforcement during the COVID-19 pandemic? We focused on traffic stops in our research, but also asked about department policies concerning social distancing during the COVID-19 pandemic. I reached out to 7 different law enforcement agencies, police departments for the cities of Harrisonburg, Stanton, and Charlottesville, and sheriff's offices for Augusta County, Rockingham County, Rockbridge County, and Page County. We asked each department these 6 questions. 1, what is your department's policy for motorists during this pandemic? 2, if a motorist is pulled over by police officers and they reasonably fear that the officer is contagious, what should the said motorist do? Can the motorist call 911 and express those fears and concerns? 4, or what if the motorist themselves believes that they are contagious and may have COVID-19? 5, how should the public practice social distancing with law enforcement? 6, what are your department's policies when it comes to social distancing within the department and when interacting with the public, including traffic stops, issuing arrest warrants, and patrolling the streets? We almost instantaneously received answers to our questions from Harrisonburg Chief of Police Eric English and Rockingham County Sheriff Brian Hutchinson. The Stanton Police Department and the Rockbridge County Sheriff's Office answered our inquiry within 24 hours. As of right now, we have not heard back from the Charlottesville Police Department, the Page County Sheriff's Office, or the Augusta County Sheriff's Office. There was a consensus among all of the departments that responded to our inquiry that officers are told to stay home if they are sick, and that officers are sent home if they display signs of illness. The departments all said they are trying to limit traffic stops during the pandemic, but that they will still enforce the law if a violation is an immediate threat or danger to the community. Rockbridge County Captain McFadden writes, quote, "We have to respond to calls for service, we have to conduct traffic stops, we have to serve warrants, and we have to patrol our communities. Crime has not stopped because of this virus. Again, though, we do ask our deputies to think about the overall picture, investigate and handle your calls, but is there an immediate threat to the public or any individual? Do I need to arrest this person now, or will our community be safe if I wait until after the virus has been cured to get a warrant and arrest the person?" Rockingham County Sheriff Brian Hutchinson said his department is trying to maintain highly visible patrols while minimizing in-person contacts. Sergeant Katie Shiflett of the Stanton Police Department writes, quote, "We have encouraged our officers to limit non-essential face-to-face contact with the public. For example, we are handling certain incidents with a phone call instead of an in-person response. But what if you still get pulled over?" Back to our question of what should you do if you think the officer stopping you is contagious? Well, the departments partially answered that question by declaring that sick officers are ordered to stay home. But to err is human, and law enforcement officers are human. As to the question, can you call 911? Sergeant Shiflett says yes, you can call the police on the police. Quote, "As always, citizens should call 911 if they have any concern. The individual pulling them over is not a legitimate law enforcement officer." Rockingham County Sheriff Brian Hutchinson says that motorists can always call 911 if they are in an emergency situation. Captain McFadden of the Rockbridge County Sheriff's Office said his department only encourages calling 911 if it is an emergency. Mike Donovan is the president and CEO of Nexus Services. His company funds a civil rights law firm and several local law firms to defend criminal defendants, as well as to fund civil litigation where they believe someone's rights have been violated. Donovan says do not be combative with officers if pulled over during the COVID-19 crisis.
Well, the most important thing to understand is that if you are being pulled over by the police, you have a duty to comply with the police commands. You have the ability to challenge what the police do when you go to court. But just deciding that you're not going to follow the commands of the police never goes well. And so the police will then use force to exert their commands. And they'll be justified in doing so simply based on the fact that you just have allowed or just decided not to follow their command. So it's important that you follow all lawfully given commands. But in the age of Corona, CV-19, and you know everything that's going on with the unconstitutional authorities that have been granted to the police by the governor, it's really, really important for people to record all police interactions. I would recommend that every single time you get pulled over, you record that from start to finish, especially now. The governor has given the police the power to imprison you because you're out of your home. These are incredible police powers never envisioned in the Constitution of the United States of America, the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia. Scary times call for measures to protect oneself, and video recording interactions with the police is incredibly important. Also, remembering that you can always call 911 and express your concerns if you're getting pulled over. If a police officer is trying to interact with you and you're concerned that he may be infected or otherwise putting your family at risk, reach out to 911, tell them what's going on, ask for a supervisor. Remember, it's very, very important to keep your family safe. It's also important to follow the commands of civil authorities. You just have to make sure that you are protecting yourself. Recording those interactions is one incredibly important way to do that.
At least two of the department's answers mentioned Virginia Governor Ralph Northam's calls for social distancing and his stay-at-home executive order. Harrisonburg Police Chief Eric English says, quote, "The public's best way to practice social distancing with law enforcement is to abide by the law and the governor's order with respect to large gatherings. We would rather not respond to calls because people in the community still feel like they can throw a party or hang out in groups at the park. We're getting calls to respond because citizens are still not taking this virus with the seriousness that it needs. We want citizens to help us mitigate our contact by following the rules." Sergeant Katie Shiflett of the Stanton Police Department says, quote, "Today's stay-at-home order issued by Governor Northam means that individuals, even those without any symptom of illness, should only be leaving their residences for food, supplies, work, medical care, or exercise/fresh air purposes," end quote. Mike Donovan said he believes the governor's orders are unconstitutional and that his company will fund civil litigation against the governor or any police department that takes criminal action against those violating the governor's order.
Even if you were to make a broad sort of effort to include this pandemic in that, there are certain things that the governor must do to declare martial law. He hasn't done any of those things. Instead, he's used a law that was passed in the year 2000, a disaster declaration law, to take all of the legislative powers conferred under that statute and use them to promulgate new criminal statutes that could potentially land Virginians in jail just for not following the governor's verbal order. This is unheard of. And of course, it's not constitutional. It's a gross and disgusting power grab. And the worst part is it's going to disproportionately affect communities of color. These ridiculous, unconstitutional orders affect more communities where there are more police. That's obviously black and brown people and socioeconomically disadvantaged white people. These are the people who are going to be affected by the governor's orders. No surprise that Governor and Attorney General Blackface are overseeing one of the biggest constitutional rights power grabs I've ever seen and doing it on the backs of black and brown Virginians. It's disgusting. We're going to file lawsuits to challenge it. But at the end of the day, what's most important is that people understand that while these laws are unconstitutional, you do not want to have conflict with the police. You want to follow lawful orders and then call us so that we can refer you to a lawyer and we can challenge those police actions in court. Remember, it's important to challenge them in court, not decide to not follow commands, which can put you and your family at risk.
In the Breaking Through Newsroom, Theodore Whitelow, Breaking Through News.